Vidhop High Secondary School. This video is for class 7 chemistry. In today's video, I will continue with the chapter that I have started with you people, that is atoms, molecules and radicals. So in my previous video, I have given you an idea about molecules are two types, molecules of an element and molecules of compound. I have given you that idea. Today I will start with the topic of atomicity. Oh, what is atomicity? What do you mean by it? So the number of atoms of an element that join together to form a molecule of that element is called atomicity of that molecule. That means how many atoms are joining to form one molecule of that element. It is termed as its atomicity. Now, atomicity is of several types. First type is monoatomic. So, what do you mean by this term monoatomic? Mono, the term mono means one. That means here only one atom is required to form a molecule of that element. Examples, sodium, Na, okay, magnesium, Mg, helium, He. You see, only one atom is required to form the molecule. That is why it is monoatomic. Next is diatomic. Here, di means two. That means two atoms required to form one molecule. Example, H2. Here you see two atoms of hydrogen combined or bound with each other to form one molecule of hydrogen. Next, O2. Here two atoms of oxygen combined to form one molecule of oxygen. Okay. Next is triatomic. Here tri means three. That means three atoms combine to form one molecule. Example, ozone or O3. O3, see, three atoms combining to form one molecule of ozone. Next is polyatomic. Here poly means many, more than three. Okay, so more than three. Example is phosphorus, P4. See, four atoms of phosphorus combine to form one molecule of phosphorus. Similarly, sulfur is eight atoms of sulfur combine to form one molecule of sulfur. So this is the atomicity and its classification. Next topic is that molecular formula of an element. We have read about molecules of an element. Now here we are reading molecular formula of an element. That means how can we write an element in a molecular formula method. That means, suppose the molecular formula of an element is the symbolic representation of its molecule. That means how we can represent it by using the symbols. Okay, it indicates the number of atoms present in it. Just like hydrogen, we write it by using the symbols is H2. From here, we can understand how many atoms are there. Okay, next is that chlorine. It is Cl2. This is the symbolic representation. This is the formula of the element. Here in the formula we can understand that it have how many atoms. Okay. So next we are going to read that from the above it is clear that H, capital H, it represents one atom of hydrogen. Okay, only H means one atom of hydrogen. one atom. Okay. Now H2 represents a molecule of hydrogen. H2 means two atoms. We know that two atoms of hydrogen bind with each other and forms one molecule of hydrogen. Understood? Next is that 2H. Okay. 2H means two atoms of hydrogen. H means one atom. So 2H means two atoms. Okay. 2H means two atoms of hydrogen. And 2H2. So H2 means one molecule. So 2H2 means it will represent two molecules of hydrogen. So in this, from this above simple and all these things, we have learned this thing, that what is or which symbol or which number is representing what. Okay. So if a numeral is written on the left hand side of a symbol, left hand side of a symbol, okay, it represents the number of atoms or molecules. Here it is atom. Here it is molecule. Why? Because H2 is only a single molecule. Okay, so when I am placing 2 in front of this H2, so it is getting 2 molecules of hydrogen. Next, we will go for the topic of radicals. We have learnt about the molecules of element compound. Now, next we will go for radicals. What do you mean by the radicals? So, radical is an atom of an element or a group of atoms of different element that behave as a single unit or with a positive or negative charge on it. So, a radical can be an atom of a single element or a group of atoms of different elements who has either a positive charge or a negative charge, but they behave similarly or as a single unit. Okay. Now, this radical is of two types. What are they? Basic radical and acid radical. Okay. Now, what is basic radical? That means they have positive charge. They have positive charge and they are called cations. The ions which are having positive charge, they are called cations. Okay. Examples are metallic ions, ammonium ion. Okay. That means metallic ion is the example. Now, coming to the acid radical, they have negative charge. Okay. And they are called as anion. And what are the examples of it? Non-metallic ions and non-metallic ions are the example of acid radical. So this is the idea about acid and basic radical. So I am keeping my video till this much. I hope you have understood till this much. In my next video, I will continue with the chapter. Thank you.